Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
For me, the history of the Japanese Akita, followed by just the way they look, and intelligent, smart, loyal. But I think the history distinguishes from that versus other dogs. Historically, the Japanese Akita came from, well, officially it's called Japanese Akita Inu, first of all. And it probably started out from two different breeds in Japan, historically speaking, centuries ago. The Kurafuto, Ken, which is a dog from South Holland, they were used as sled dogs, and the Matagi Inu, which is a hunter's dog. For those two dogs, it was one for hunting and for sled dogs, and then later on it became more of a guard dog for nobility and landowners. And then maybe around 1800s, it became more of a fighting dog, as in, yeah, fighting in a dog fighting. It's that point that foreign dogs were introduced to Japan around after 1850 or so, somewhere in that ballpark. So they wanted to make that dog even a better fighter. So they have introduced the Akitas to other breeds. There's German Shepherds, British St. Bernards, Mastiffs are in there. Maybe two other breeds, I believe. So slowly it was kind of evolving into a different breed. To a point where late 1800s, early 1900s, it was probably at its impurest form. Not all of them were like that, mind you. A lot of purists. And the government was like, hey, this is getting too far out. We should try to preserve it. And so then they evolved they formed the Japanese Akita Preservation Society, which is called Akio or Akita Inu Hozonkai. And that was around 1920, I believe. So they were working towards making that dog pure again. But you're starting to see some traits on the Akita that's not the original dog. Unfortunately, World War II happened, so that was stopped on the stop trying to blend out or the European traits or the foreign traits of the dog. And so when the war was over, there was more of a population issue. So they're just breeding what dogs they had left because the population was decimated. And once they got the population to a good size, they started going back to the original mandate, which was trying to breed out all the foreign characteristics of these dogs to make it a pure dog. Well, unfortunately, after World War II, a lot of servicemen in the 50s brought American Akitas, or the Akitas from Japan, over to the United States, and they started breeding them here. But it's not like they were communicating with the Japanese breeders, right? The distance, language barrier, there's no internet, nobody's calling over the phone because of language barrier. So the American breeders are breeding one way, and Japanese breeders are trying to breed out the foreign traits. And so what you got is, you start maybe late 60s, 70s, you're starting to see very different dogs. AKC recognized the Akita around the early 70s. And Akiho, a branch of the Japanese Preservation Society, was formed in 1970. We were working on trying to preserve the breed here. But by then, there's a debate now as time goes along. To a point where some American breeder says, hey, our dog's the original dog. You know, we should just preserve that, or have two separate breeds. And then another group, most of them are saying we should just combine them again and go back to where it was after World War II, during the fighting dogs. But they didn't know about the history, right? They're just going by looks, right? Helen Keller, by the way, is the first American that officially brought an Akita over from Japan. So if you look at her dogs, it's like, wait, our dogs look more like Helen Keller dogs than the Japanese Akita's Inus now. So they're trying to go back to that. But so there's a split. People who want two separate breeds and one wants to blend together. So that's how we formed the Japanese Akita Club of America to promote the two different breeds to the AKC and other United States organizations like United Kennel Club. UKC recognized two separate breeds about 10 years ago or so, but the American Kennel Club just recognized the two separate breeds about a year or two ago. But we're at the the bottom stage of recognition for AKCs. Next year, we're going up to miscellaneous class, and after miscellaneous class, we have to do all these things, then we get promoted to full recognition by the AKC, but that's gonna take time. AKC is the only kennel club, major kennel club, that does not recognize two separate breeds in the world. Everybody does. FCI, which is the International Kennel Club, all the European kennel clubs, Canadian Kennel Club recognizes two separate breeds. So AKC is the last major kennel club to recognize two separate breeds of American Akita and Japanese Akita Inu. There's many differences and some similarities. The biggest differences from a layperson is probably the size. American Akitas are typically over 100 pounds, maybe 110, 140. Japanese Akitas are gonna be under 100, typically 50 pounds to 80, 85 maybe pushing it. So size is the obvious difference. Standard in the pattern and color of the fur, there is no standard for the American Akita. It could be stripes, any color, pinto pattern, brindle pattern. For the Japanese Akita Inu, there's only three major colors, which is the red, brindle, which is a stripe, and the white. Now, the red could have lighter and darker red, and the brindles could have red brindles, a darker brindle, a silver brindle. But those are generally the three main colors or patterns, is the red, the brindle, and the white. And that's it, nothing else for the Japanese Akita. And then if you look more closely at these two breeds, it's all about the face at that point. You know, most notably, I would say the American Akita looks more like a German Shepherd ears almost. It's like they're longer and the ears are closer together, whereas Japanese Akita Inu, which are shorter, further apart, so there's more space between the ears, more symmetrical on the triangular shape of the ears, and it tilts a little bit more than the American Akita, and they're typically thicker too than the American Akita. Other things is the Japanese Akitas tends to have the almond-shaped eyes or triangular-shaped eyes, whereas American Akitas are typically the round eyes. The Japanese Akitas are typically have the smaller muzzle, more roundish in shape, whereas the American Akita has more of a, if you look straight at the muzzle, more kind of a squarish look, longer muzzle than the Japanese Akita Inu. So originally, like I said, it was probably for like pulling sleds and hunting that evolved to being a guard dog. Now it's more, then fighting, of course, unfortunately. There's the fighting period of the history of the dog. But currently, it's more of like a companion dog now and a guard dog. For probably those are the two main things in Japan. Yeah.